Hello friends, let's start with the today session. Today they are going to perform file handling operations using WinForm in C sharp. Okay, so now basically to perform read and write operation on the file, we need to use the stream classes, and there are two types of stream classes. One is a stream reader, which allows the user to read the content of the file, and another one is a stream writer, which allows the user to write the data into the file. Basically, we can perform these operations without using WinForms also. So today we are going to see how to perform these operations using GUI by creating one small desktop applications. Okay, for that reason we have implemented this small application. This is going to read the data onto the file and to perform the write operation, means saving the file on our desktop. Okay, let's see. So now here to perform these operations we have used the text box. This one is nothing but the text box. Okay, let's see the properties, and his name is textbox1. Okay, the important thing is what? When we drag and drop this text file here, we are getting a single line. So if he wants to make it as a large, then it's not a possible. So to perform this operation, we need to make the multi-line is equals to true. Okay, now otherwise you can perform this operation with the help of here, or you can also select, go and just select the multi-line and just drag this. Okay, in this way we have created this list box. Okay, and today we are going to perform read, write, clear and close operations. Okay, so to perform read operation we have created these four buttons. Okay, so now the first, read. So read caption and its name was button 1, and for the write it's a button 2, close button 3, and clear it's a button 4. So in this way we have created four buttons. So let's start for writing the code for read operations. Already I have written the code, everything. Okay, so while performing the read the data from the file, what we need to do? Whenever we are going to read anything, at that time we need to use open dialog box. Okay, that open dialog box is going to give us a facility to select a particular file from our desktop. Okay, so for that reason we have used open file dialog. Okay, this open file dialog is open the file dialog box. Okay, so now OFD is the object of that open file dialog, and here we have placed the filter, which allows us to select a particular type of the file, means here we are going to select .txt file. Okay, so it should have the valid names, and the multiple selection is the false because we are going to select a single file for read operation. Okay, so now here if everything is okay, it means open ofd.showDialogBox is equals to dialogResult.ok, then we came to the here. So now it's a stream reader. Now stream reader allows us to read the data from the file. Okay, means for whenever we'll open this particular open dialog box, at that time we are going to select a particular file, right? So that file's details are going to be listed in this SR object. Okay, so now this, with the help of this SR object, we can read the data from the file. Let's see. For that reason we have created one string variable that is going to hold the data from that particular file, and finally we are going to put that data, which sr.object has sr.read to end has given, to the textbox1.txt. Okay, let's see the working of this read operation. We'll run this code. Okay, now it's building. Build successful. Yes, and this is fine. Okay, now this is our text box and the read operation. So to perform the read operation, we need to click here. It's going to open one open dialog box. Okay, and now we are going to select the particular file, like text.txt file. Let's open this file. So now here we have opened the particular file. Okay. So now let's say I want to open some more files. Then C#. We'll open that file. Hi, this is C#. Okay. So now let's study C#. Okay, it means I have written some data here and I want to save this file. Then what? Click on the right button and then select C# and then click. It's going to give us one message that whether you want to replace it. Yes, you want to replace it and written successful. We'll see this operation, but now currently we'll see this read operation. Okay, let's clear everything and then read again this C# file. Yes, this is the data. Okay, so in this way, we are going to perform the read operation from a particular file. Now let's see the write operation. As we have already said, to perform the write operation, we need to use the stream writer. Okay. Now, to write the data onto the system, at that time, it's mandatory to write or to create one file on the desktop. Okay. It means what? First of all, we need to create one file and we need to write some data and then we can save that file. So for that reason, we need to use here save file dialog box. Right? So this save file dialog box will open the save file dialog box and here we have created a SFD as the object. Again, what is going to be saved? It is going to save the .txt file and it should have the value. And if everything is okay, then what? It will come to the stream writer. Okay. Now here stream writer SW is the object. Now, when we are going to perform this write operation, we need to select particular file. It means where should we write? Okay. So now here it will give us a file name. This SFD is nothing but the object of this save dialog file. Whatever file we have created at that time, that name will be given to you. And now, while performing the write operation, now sw.writeline. Okay, that sw.writeline is going to take the data from the textbox1.txt. Okay, and then when we click on the save, it is going to save the file and it will finally display the message. The return has been successful. Or the write operation has been successful. Okay, so in this way we can write the code for the write operation. Now this one is nothing but the read operation. Okay, hope so everyone is getting. So let's run this code. It's building and it's built successful. Okay, now let's first create one file. Okay, now let's say paste.txt file. Okay, now we have written successfully, right? But what? We haven't written anything, but it has been created one file here, paste file. Let's see the content. Nothing. We have nothing written here. We have simply just created a file. Then we'll create. Then we'll click on that file and that button. Okay. Now, if you write something here, hi, this is John. Okay. Now I want to write the data to that file. Then click on the write and then select the test file. Okay. Do you want to replace it? Yes. And it will be successful. Now, successfully we have written. Now let's read the another file. Click on the read and then click on the text.txt file and let's open it. Okay. The data from that text file has been displayed. Okay. Now let's read the test file. What we have written in this file? We have written a simple user join in this way. Let's say if you want to write the data of this file to this file, then yes, we can overwrite that one. Written successfully. Let's see what we have done here.
now. Let's see.
Test.txt, here we have created, right? File, let's start with the bin form and let's start with the file handler. Okay, and now here the same thing because we have replaced the data, right? And now C sharp. Hi, this is Sharp. Let's study C sharp. So here we have created the three files. Okay, so now clear is a button which is used to clear this text box, and last one is a close, which is going to close this application. So in this simple way, we can perform the file read and write operation using DynamoDocs. Hope so everyone will got this content. Try to implement this simple application. Thank you.